what keeps me up at night about this issue of gay marriage is that other people stay up at night thinking about gay marriage. You know, I identify as somebody who, you know, is very kind of concerned with how things affect me, how they affect my family. But in terms of how this affects other people, you know, I don't get it. A lot of times we hear, well, you know, they don't have family values, or they're not, you know, a traditional family because they don't value the same things we do, or think that the same morals we think are important matter. And that's just not true. My moms are two of the most loving and committed people I've ever had the pleasure of knowing. And there are nights I remember Jackie holding Tari, who's 6-7 inches taller than she is, as Tari just laid on the bed whimpering in pain from her multiple sclerosis, and watching that. And, you know, my mom's taught me once that love is giving somebody the power to destroy you and trusting them not to. And my mom's taught me that, not just by saying it, but by showing it to me and to my sister. When I hear that folks are staying up at night worried about the scourge of same-sex marriage, I wonder who these people are, and I wish they could come over and have dinner with me and my moms and just get to know us on a personal level, because I think fundamentally love is love, and the idea that we should be recognizing, you know, one kind of relationship between straight people, but say that, well, gay love, that's not real love, you know, it doesn't really deserve our recognition. That's not what America is about. And I think that at the end of the day, Americans are going to recognize that the power of love is greater than the power of fear.